Welcome to another episode of Last Humans Garage. In this episode, we are going to change the front rotors to free-floating rotors, lightweight rotors, two-piece rotors, various names. That's what we're going to be doing today to the front. If you've been following the story, which I hope you have, you might remember that when I put on these sweet A5 19-inch wheels that I bought local, I got full confirmation they're A5 from some of the Facebook groups. So A5 wheels, and the Sparkos were inside these rubbers here, which are getting picked up in a couple hours by one of our regular channel posters that you see, regular name. I won't mention them because I haven't asked them. And the problem was, these were, I'd have to watch my video, 46, 47 pounds, maybe 48, wheel and tire package, right? Then I went to these, like 54 pounds, I think. I don't think it was 55, might have been 53, 54. So it was a good 4 to 5 pound raise on each corner. That's the whole backstory. So I've always been thinking about club sport rotors, stuff like that, the lightweight rotors, to get back some of that 5 pounds I lost on each wheel by running these mega 255 35 19s. Stock, I think. I don't know. One thing I plan to do is get 245s whenever I can switch these out. This is a bit too wide for me. It's also just, it is going to mess up the paint, you know. And as soon as you hear me say that, no, I'm not, I don't want to clear bra this and go through all that stuff. It's a car, I'm going to enjoy it, you know. But I'm just saying, I might go one size smaller tire on this just to have it a quarter inch better fit, you know, whatever. It might be barely noticeable. But let's get down to the good stuff here. Let's check out the rotors. You know we're doing a weigh test. That's the most exciting thing of this whole video. All right, let's open these up and see what we got in here, guys. All right, SL left New Speed. I love New Speed parts. I always have had them from forever. Woo, my hands clean. Oh, look at that thing. Wow. Cool, cool, cool. You get a little something like that, maybe. That'll give it a nice light. There we go. So yeah, this is a two-piece. You don't touch any of the bolts and all that stuff. Be cool if this actually lasts longer than some of the, you know, the black powers, all your stop techs, your powers, all that powder coated stuff, which actually lasts pretty good, to be honest. But I wonder if this is better or the same or what. It almost looks like it's better. It's almost like, but you know, maybe it's just the same surface. It actually looks really, really tight and clean. Make sure this other one's here, and hopefully it should be the opposite curvature. Good. Yeah, it is the opposite curvature. So there's number two. Oh, I'll show you here. Audi S3 and Mark 75R or whatever. Mark 7R. 340 by 30, it says. That's 340 mil pizza by 30 thick. Yeah, I don't know. One thing I noticed, I think the stockers will have a much thicker bit here, which you kind of want for heat, to absorb heat, right? But, you know, of course, you have weight, so maybe it's a compromise of everything, you know? We're going to compare them for sure. All right, let me get started. I haven't even got the car up yet. All right, guys, we are ready to begin. We got jacks on each side here. And then we also got a couple safety jacks just for emergencies, even though I don't plan to really get under it, but you know, I also might turn the wheels a bit per some other guys' tips to make it much easier to torque some of those when I'm done. So I'm going to start out by getting the calipers off. I'm going to use one of my sweet Capri flat wrenches. I don't think this might be too small. Yeah, it's the 1617 that I need. Hold on. Which is a bit thicker, but still plenty able to do the job. Perfect. Now that we're holding that, we'll go ahead with the 13 and bust those two off and get the caliper off. I'll probably get a little tie wrap in my hand first and then just tie wrap it here, keep it out of the way while we work. But guys, I'm not really gonna film like as much as I usually do. You've seen brake jobs plenty of times, but I am just showing you. I just found the perfect hole in the strut, which I didn't even know was there. Of course it is if you look. So yeah, it just hangs there perfectly, keeping not too much tension on that brake cable hose, no extreme bend. So ready to take off the pads. You know what this will allow me to show you though, is that little custom light delete thing that I made. I did not cut anything and I just kind of popped it in there like that. I may even leave it like that. I probably won't even connect it to the OEMs again. There's really no point in reversing this now. All right guys, now I can get these out with my hands as soon as you break them loose. Now I'm gonna have to look up these torques again. I can't remember. And I may even clean again these slider areas on the calipers just because it's an all new setup. I wanna just have it perfect. So I'm gonna go ahead and just do an extra clean on these even though I just did a brake job like a little while ago. Yeah, it's kind of cruddy. I wanna actually clean it up. Figure out, I wanna get rid of. Took a while, see all that dirt, but I finally got them satisfactory where they're smooth at least. They were like rough on my fingers before. Now they're smooth. I'll put a tiny anti-seize or some brake lube from one of my brake kits in there now that it's super clean, and it should be better than new. I'll also spend a few minutes getting some of these extras. I don't know why I'm bothering. It's gonna be dirty in like a couple days anyway. And now it's time for the main event, folks. We are gonna do the weigh off, everything you've wanted to see on this, and see how much are we saving with these two rotors, all right? This is gonna be epic. Recall from the start of the video, approximately 5 pounds is what I'm a deficient in right now. Whatever that means. I gotta do stock first, or no, this isn't stock. Power stop. No. I think it's stop tech. Stop tech. This is a stop tech for sure. Sorry guys, I go through so many different types of brakes. These are stop tech rotors, and I do recall they weighed maybe a pound more than the stockers, or a half pound more than the stockers. Could have been coincidence, but that's what I remember. All right, let's go. Stock, like this. Here we go, let's go in. Where's my number? Okay. 23.6. Let's just keep the camera right here. 23.6. Ah! All right, wait for it to disappear. I gotta take off my damn glove because it doesn't let my touch work on the screen. All right, it's off. 23.6, right? Here we go. Ow, okay, let's go. 23.6. What do we got? Yeah! Okay, 18.2. I thought it was 18.0. Super sick. Wow. 23.6, 18.2. 23.6, 18.2. 23.6, 18.2. 23.6, 18.2. 23.6, 18.2. 23.6, 18.2. 23.6, 18.2. 5.5. Looks like, yeah, I did that right. I had to have 5.5 pounds. 5.5 would be 5.5. Why not cheat at a tenth? Dude, wait. The new wheels were 5 pounds heavier. The new rotors are 5 pounds lighter. I'm gonna get my power back.
Pretty nice. Pretty nice indeed, isn't it?